I guess it kind of suits my personality. I'm good at bossing people around, I guess. I don't know, but.
Good morning, everybody. Take a look at this amazing little Amazon tree boa. This is one of the ones I got a couple weeks ago, and holy cow, is it looking amazing. I absolutely love this little monkey. I cannot wait till it gets a little bigger to see what kind of colors it's going to turn into. It's going to be a really amazing addition to some of my Amazons that I'm already raising up, and I hope that you guys are having an amazing start to your day. Let me know how your day is going. Oh, and by the way, I wanted to tell you guys, I think there's only 1 or 2 days left to get your new merch, so definitely check that out. Because come on, I mean, don't you want to be sporting some Bella Banana swag? I mean, it is awesome. And again, it comes in long sleeve, it comes in a hoodie, comes in a couple different colors, like for instance, one right here is, look, take a look at this. This is freaking absolutely awesome. I mean, seriously, you guys only have 1 or 2 days left and this merch is gonna be gone forever. You definitely don't want to miss out on this one. Hey, you know what? I tell you what, there's another merch I'm thinking about doing. Let me know what you think about this one. Here you go. What do you guys think? Is this a great shirt or what? Okay, it's space with kittens puking up rainbows. Don't worry, guys. This is not actually the merch I'm going to be doing. But anyways, get yourself some merch and let me know something awesome about you guys down in the comments. What do you say we just push our problems aside and had a good time today? You know, I've had such an amazing journey over this incredible life of animals ever since I was a teenager all the way till now. And you guys have gotten to know me pretty well. I mean, let's face it, I have vlogged every single day for almost a year and a half now. So certainly you guys have learned just about everything you need to know about me. But that being said, if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below and I'll cover it if you want. But the one constant in this ever-changing evolution of dealing with animals for me has really been Lori. So I thought we'd take some time and let you guys get a little bit more acquainted with Lori and what she's all about.
Honestly, if somebody would have asked me many, many years ago if I would have ever been involved with a reptile, 100%. My answer would be no way, because I could never have imagined what my life turned into. Not that I would change it if I could go back now, but it's pretty funny because I didn't grow up around them. It wasn't my thing and neither was my family. So it took years and years for even my family to get used to what we do. It turned out to be pretty cool.
Take a look at this pastel genetic stripe that just ovulated. Look at how big and gravid she looks. You know, I tell people all the time that I'm kind of a little bit of a visionary. I always have ideas. I have all kinds of plans. Sometimes they're completely crazy and out of control. But the truth is that I always say that I can see A and I can see Z, the finish line, but sometimes the alphabet gets a little bit blurry to me. So it's important for people like me that are kind of a little bit manic that you need someone like Lori that can basically put the other letters of the alphabet together. Throughout my entire life as an adult, I've had Lori there when I've had an idea or some crazy scheme and I've said, I really want to do this and I want to get to here and I think we can do this and we could do that and look what's going to happen once we do all these things. And the truth is Lori has always been the one that has kind of implemented my idea and then the plan of attack to get us to where we want to go. Now it's not always worked out and most of the time that's because the idea was bad. Lori is really good at organizing, keeping things together, and certainly executing a plan.
Brian has always been a big idea guy and I'm totally okay with that and I'm used to that now. Sometimes it drives me crazy because sometimes I do get sick of the ideas because usually all of the ideas come with a lot of work involved. And he's really great at throwing them out there, but somehow a lot of times I'm the one who has to figure out how we have to do it. If I had to come up with Brian's worst idea, it's kind of hard because there's been some doozies. But I guess the first one that pops into my head, wanting to raise maple trees in my backyard. Hundreds of maple trees he wanted to plant. I don't know why. Fortunately, I was able to squash that one. Probably a close second would be raising emus in our tiny postage stamp backyard in our first house. That was another one. I could just keep going on. There was a lot of really bad ones.
Let me tell you something, and I don't think this is going to come as much as a surprise to you guys, but anyone that has been around us knows this. Lori is absolutely the boss. Not only here at BHB Reptiles, but basically she runs the show at my house and everywhere else. You know, as much as I kind of am the alpha male in a sense, the truth is that Lori kind of keeps me in check. If it wasn't for Lori, I don't know where I'd be, because I'm always coming up with crazy ideas and things to do, and I want to keep everything, and I want to grow, and I want to do stuff. And Lori is the one that kind of keeps the reins pulled in, and she certainly is the boss here at BHB.
My main job is basically being the boss and in charge of everything that's going on. I guess it kind of suits my personality. I'm good at bossing people around, I guess. I don't know, but I think I do all right with it. Some days I'd rather not, but most days I'm all right making sure everything gets done and keeping on top of everything. Dealing with Brian is pretty much a full-time job in and of itself. He always keeps me on my toes. I never know what's coming at me next. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. Some days I'm happy, some days I literally want to choke him out.
Unlike me, that was kind of born with the love of reptiles. I've told the story. My first memory ever as a kid was of a reptile, and I've just been obsessed with animals. You know, Lori wasn't that way. When I met her, she literally was afraid of reptiles. Over the years, she kind of became tolerant of them, and then in all honesty, she's kind of grown a love and a desire for them. I love it when I see Lori kind of lighten up when we produce something cool or we get a new animal. She sometimes will try to play like she doesn't like them, but I know she does. I think it's amazing that she's went from being really afraid of them to surrounding herself with them and now appreciating them so much.
I fully believe that loving and appreciating reptiles is something that you can gain as you grow. Some people are just born with that unexplainable just love and passion for them. Others are fearful. I was on the other side to where I honestly was scared of them because I wasn't around them. And then over the years, I was able to, by being introduced to them, coming across them and caring for them, I actually was able to grow an appreciation for them. Just because I wasn't always a reptile lover doesn't mean that I wasn't an animal lover my whole life. We always grew up with different pets, mainly dogs. And obviously, I love my dogs. They're like my furry children, especially as my children have grown up. You know, my dogs become like my babies. Honestly, part of me wants probably 5 or 6 more. But the difference between Brian and I is I realize what work that entails, and that's why I don't have them. Unlike him, who will add hundreds of animals at a whim. That's what keeps me from having probably 10 dogs in my life right now.
You know, I love spending my time around these animals like this beautiful pastel pied. And you know, you guys know that I'm kind of in an evolution. The truth is over my entire career, I've always been evolving. But now I've kind of evolved from being like a reptile breeder as my main passion and interest to kind of educating and changing. And that means there's a lot of change going on in my life. You know, sure, I'll still breed reptiles, and still I'm going to do my best to provide amazing animals for people that want pets and even want to do entry-level breeding. I'm not nearly as interested in the investment side of reptiles anymore. I'm more interested in kind of the educational side and entertaining side and just getting people excited about it, which means that Lori has to always kind of come along for that journey. I always check with her and make sure that she's on board, because I never want to do anything that she doesn't want to go forward with. And the truth is, I think the most successful people are always evolving to what they think is the best next steps in their life.
What's next on the horizon for us? I would say definitely the near future is working on the mini zoo. I think that's going to be pretty exciting, and hopefully if everything can come together the way we're envisioning it, I think that's a pretty cool thing. I feel like there's some other things that can also kind of branch off of that. I'm not really sure. Sometimes things just have to kind of evolve. As it's happening, you just kind of have to go with it. Let's just see what pops up.
You know, most people that know me know that I'm really a passionate guy, but I have lots of other passions, not just animals. I mean, I love animals, but I love to kind of do all kinds of things. I'm a huge movie buff. I love to play sports. I'm into the gym. I'm into just kind of learning about almost everything. I love cryptozoology. I love aliens. I love all kinds of different things. And I think that's what makes life so good, is to be a rounded person and kind of have a curiosity for everything.
The kind of things I like to do when I'm not working, probably along the lines of creative things. I've always liked to do stuff like that ever since I was a kid, whether it's arts or crafts or, you know, quilting, you know, making things. So I think I can add a little bit that more in my life than I have. I also love reading, just kind of chilling out, spending time with my dog. Probably the only thing I can remember ever wanting to do when I was young was to be an astronaut. And obviously that did not happen. So other than that, once I was 18 and graduated, that I realized that was not going to happen. So at that point, I really didn't have any clue what hit. Retirement is a weird word, and it means different things to different people. While yes, in some ways I say I feel that I would like to retire, but my retire isn't basically, okay, I'm 100% done working, I'm gonna sit my butt on the couch and just never leave the house, which some people think. I kind of feel retirement is scaling back, being able to kind of step out of some of the more intensive, stressful things, and pretty much being able to like pick and choose what work I wanna do and when I wanna do it. I think having a life to where, you know, I'm busy and it's set, but then I'm able to just unplug from it and go on a trip or decide to go on vacation for a month. That's kind of what I think retirement would be.
The truth is, guys, is that life is never perfect, and relationships have struggles here and there. I couldn't imagine sharing my life with anyone else. Lori has been there since I was a teenager, and we've shared and experienced so many different things, and certainly my success couldn't be nearly what it is today or what it might be in the future without her. So I am very lucky to have her, and I know that you guys love her too, so now you know a little bit more about her. And with that said, I'm going to go ahead and end the vlog here. I hope that you have an absolutely amazing day, evening, morning, whenever you happen to be watching it. Your support means the world to me, and I know it means the world to Lori as well. We both love you guys so much, and we cannot tell you how much we appreciate you. Can you do me a couple favors before we get out of here? Can you smash that like button, as well as turn on those post notifications so you know when I upload a video, which is every day, 7 days a week at 9 o'clock in the morning Eastern Standard Time. And remember, the times changed recently, so now it's an hour earlier. Remember to be kind to someone today, and I promise I'm going to see you guys tomorrow.